Hi everyone, Victor is here. Today I'm on my balcony and I'll try to sketch a found still life. This table with all the toy food was prepared by my daughter. She was playing here on the balcony. She was doing a picnic on the balcony, so today's sketch is for letter P, for a picnic or playground. This is a view from my balcony. In the distance we can see Basara Bridge. And closer, a tower that is being demolished. In that place now is being built a residential park. And closest is Grand Bridge. For today's sketch, I'll be using gouache or tempera. So far I've been quite reluctant to use gouache because after I use it, it hardens on the palette and it's quite difficult to re-wet it. I just cleaned up this palette. It had gouache hardened on the surface. It was quite difficult to clean it up, so I'll try today other brand of gouache. From Maimeri. I'll do my sketch on this hot pressed watercolor paper made by Schut, 300 gsm. Hot pressed means it's a smooth surface. I chose this paper because I find it more suitable for gouache because it glides smoothly and it's more appropriate for gouache. I will start with a quick sketch with a pencil, 3B pencil. So it's called found still life because I didn't arrange anything. The objects of the subject were found as they are. So I didn't move anything. I'll indicate the main shapes of the subject. Here is a picnic stool. Gouache is quite similar to watercolor. It is more opaque and you can cover with it the underdrawing or the previous layers. Yet if it is used with a lot of water, it can be used as a watercolor. It can be diluted and can be applied in thin washes. Here are some lines of the stool. It's quite intricate. It's a foldable stool. Sometimes I used this tool for painting outdoor on plein air sessions. Here is a table in front. Try to figure out these lines. They are quite intricate. Here it is a bit curved. It's not so straight. I'll correct this now. Another line here. Intersections. The behind. Here. Another one. So here we have a red bucket with toys. My daughter likes to play at the balcony because it's sunny and it's like being outside. This composition is very colorful. That's why also I choose to use gouache. Gouache can be applied in very vivid colors. The colors are very bright for the toys. So I'll indicate quickly the shapes. Later on, the drawing can be corrected if something went wrong with some measurements or proportions, because gouache is quite forgiving compared to watercolor. We can correct at any stage. Being opaque, it covers. Yet, not too many layers is advisable to put, because the previous layers can be re-wetted by the last one, and the color might get muddy. So in gouache also, careful planning needs to be done in advance. Here's a donut on the table. Some slices of pizza. Orange. A piece of I think it's from making juice. Okay, French fries, rectangular shape. Here are some peas. Okay. Small bottles of fuzzy drinks. So I put the colors on the palette in order of the temperature: ultramarine blue, cobalt blue, green, burnt umber, madder, lake red, red, orange, yellow, yellow ochre, and white. The brushes I'll be using are synthetic brushes of different sizes and shapes. What I've learned about gouache is that we don't need too much water. This container, I find it is enough to mix the colors. I'll start with the biggest shape. I'll mix grayish color for the stool. In gouache mixing takes I think more time than in watercolor before applying on paper. I need to test some colors. So I'll apply directly the color and I'll try to follow the shapes so that the sketch would be in one layer, to not come back later and to adjust anything. This is just a quick sketch. With this rectangular brush you can do broad shapes or finer ones with the tip of the brush, just with the corner. Some fine lines can be done. I'm trying to wipe the brush every time I'm taking another color, so the colors start to dry. Now I need to use a spray bottle to keep them wet. For the lines of the stool, I'll try to mix the black. I'm not using pure black. I'll mix burnt umber with the ultramarine blue. Now I will paint the negative part of the table. Negative painting means to paint around the objects and to follow their external shape, because I have here grayish, I'll use I think smaller brush with a flat shape. I found gouache very useful for plein air painting instead of oil painting, because for oil painting it's quite difficult to bring along all the solvents, turpentine and oil, and to mix them. Also for the oil painting after the painting session, the canvas needs to be carried carefully, because it dries longer than the gouache. Gouache dries on the spot, while for oil painting we need to wait at least a week before it dries. I tried to paint with oils on plein air sessions, and yeah, it's more satisfying. Yet gouache also is very versatile. So just look, where are other blue objects in this still life? I think here it's a spoon. It wasn't a drone yet. We can add with the gouache easily after that. And there is a plate of this lilac color. I think it's more brighter. Okay. Other blue colors I can see so far. I move to the red color, bright red, and I'll cover all the red bright red. So this bucket is red, later one we can add the highlights and some shadow. So far I'll cover only the general shape. I'll use this one. have here plenty of objects in red. Today's sketch is about a picnic at the balcony. It was done with gouache. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you are well. Thanks for watching. Bye.